Hi everyone, this is Aki with another Divi video, trying to go over some ideas about how to use and rows and columns in Divi. So I just put it here like a sample page with some examples so we can go over. I'm going to show you on the visual builder side, so I'm just going to click on that to show you how it is organized. How the layout is organized. So the main things I want to go over quickly is just the different types of sections in Divi. So whenever you want to add a section, you have this plus, you can select it, and you have three different sections. You have full width. So these are really, you can put modules that spans the whole width. So I'm going to show you one like here. And there are no rows beside just one row. So everything's going to span across. Now, then you have this other option, which is specialty. If you click on that, that basically will show you specific layouts that usually includes, like right here, what I have. This is a module. There are no rows, so everything will just span that section, but you can add different modules. And this section, actually, you can divide it into different rows. So I'll show you that as well. Now, then we go to the regular section. So this is a regular section. So this is the first option, regular. When you select it, you have an option to specify the number of rows. You can always change it when you click on the row and you have this change column structure. And you can change it even after you decide how you want to lay it out. So right now I have three columns. If I want to change it, I can do select this, and now it's going to be two. Now you can also do it differently by clicking that plus button that you have between the two columns, and this way you can make it three, and then you can, you know, drag the modules to a different column if you want to lay it out differently. Okay, that didn't work. My computer is slow right now. Okay, now it's working. So this is one way. So now let's get over how the specialty sections in Divi, how they work. So the specialty section, when you want to do a specialty section, it's basically what you're doing is having one section of rows and another section of modules. And the difference with the specialty sections is once you decide on the type, like if you click on this, it gives you these different options. The ones in orange, that's actually the modules. That's where the modules will go. And the green ones are the rows. So this section, for example, will have rows that you can specify 1, 2, 3, however you like. But then this section will be modules. So you won't be able to add rows. So right now I have this specialty section, and you see there is no option to change it. So if you decide, you know, later on that you want a different layout, you can change the row section to, let's say, having more rows, but you cannot change the module sections to different row section, to having more rows. So you can add different modules and so on, but you cannot change the layout for the rows and columns. So that's important to know ahead. So sometimes, like, but these sections are good to have a like a interesting layout. You see, I put this here with the use of the specialty section. So they're kind of like, they're not proportional. They're kind of like offsetting a little bit. So these are good for like something like a blog that you may want to make it more interesting. And I think that's all I can think of. And oh, again, let me show you the one that's full width. You see, the full width, once you specify what kind of module you want, there is no way to add columns. That's pretty much just full width. So you can add different modules, but you cannot divide it into subsections. And I think that's all I can think of right now. But hopefully that helps you, you know, create more interesting layouts in Divi. So thanks for watching.